would hit basically.
Nope.
So almost 2 years, we have not been seeing that. So
nope.
Give Jared a call about that.
Get
some more information on that. Okay. Talk to me. Another product that Jared's got that I'm talking to him personally about is your line of credit product. So let's talk about that a little bit.
Yep. So the line of credit is really useful in a couple different capacities, but probably the most, I guess, popular way that people use it is for, if we're following the Burr method, for the buy and the rehab of your property. So it's a line of credit, and it's not a line of credit that most people think of, like a HELOC, where you can just go, you know, use it as basically cash. It is a line of credit that you would submit property applications on to use on the line. So it's experience based. So, you know, I'll talk kind of on the brand new people first, and then it gets a little bit better. But basically, you're going to get at minimum a $500,000 line of credit. And that line of credit, as a new, brand new investor, never done one of these before, you would have to bring, you know, we talk about loan to value, you know, a lot. I'm also going to talk loan to cost. And loan to cost is your purchase price and your rehab budget combined. So you would have to bring 15% of your cost out of pocket up front, and we'll finance the rest. And then it's really a hard money loan is what it is. It's underwritten a little bit more in detail than a hard money loan. Your rates are a little bit better than hard money loans. You have up to 18 months per property, and you can go up to 20 units on this. So you can really start getting into those you know, apartment complexes and things like that.
Okay.
But if you do have some experience, you know, and when I talk experience, there's a couple tiers. Once you hit three properties and once you hit five properties from an experience level, now it goes to only a 10% down of your cost and then to a 5% down payment of your cost. So it really, the whole point of that is to scale, right? It gives you the money to buy the property, to rehab your property, and then to do it multiple times over without having to use all of your cash up front. So that's probably the most popular reason people use it. You can also use it to purchase turnkey ready properties that maybe have a little bit lower price point and don't fit into the mold of, you know, a true commercial loan. And you can do these in your LLC too, which is another major, major thing. You can do new construction in this from ground up. You do have to have at least one new construction project under your belt for us to do that. Or if you have a partner that wants to join an LLC, you can do new construction. You can do refinances, short-term refinances on this. So if you do buy a property cash, but you want to finance in your rehab cost into that, we can use this as a refinance to recoup your purchase price and give you the rehab money.
So can you do multiple projects at the same time, or do you really need to do one at a time? Okay, so you can't.
No, I mean, as long as you got the sanity and the people to be able to do multiple projects at one time.
That is true.
As long as you got the room on the line of credit and you've got the cash available, then absolutely you can do multiple of these.
Okay, so let's just walk through a scenario on just like a $100,000 property. Let's say it's a newbie, so he's got to put that $15,000 down. What does that look like on a $100,000 property?
Say that one more time.
So we're going to do a $100,000 property. Okay. And this is a newbie. So he's got to be at the 15%. So do I need to already be at, do I need to purchase the property for $70,000 to get that ARV or where are we there?
Yeah. I mean, so what would happen on that? You know, if the property, let's say you purchased it for $70,000 and it needs $30,000 worth of work. So you've got a total cost of $100,000 on this. So yeah, you would have to bring $15,000 out of pocket on that. You know, plus your closing costs, which range, right? It's going to vary depending on you. Yeah. And then also you're going to have reserves on that as well. So I always tell people for a newbie doing this exact example of $100,000 cost, you're going to have about $30,000 in the bank. And you're only going to spend about 20 of it. You just have to show us that you got 30. That changes a lot, you know, once you get to 10%, plus your reserves go down, where that same project, you only have to have about 20,000 in the bank.
So with those reserves, does that have to be in cash, or can it be sitting in stock market or mutual funds or something like that?
Good question. Yeah, it can be in any account that is potentially liquid.
Okay. All right. Yep. So that sounds
Roth IRAs, stocks, things like that.
Okay. All right. Any other tips you want to give us on that product?
No, I think minimum loan amount on it is $50,000. Okay. You know, which gives you quite a bit of flexibility, especially in the indie market. And that's a combination of your purchase plus rehab. So I think that one gives you a ton of flexibility, and really utilizes your cash to do this over and over again. So on that one, it's, yeah, just get yourself a property and let's go.
Right. Yeah. So, and this is one that Jared and I have been talking about myself for mine, because I'm at a point now where I'm like, okay, I'm rolling. I want to buy another one, but I'm getting a little bit short on cash. What are some other options for me? Yep. And I think this would kind of be perfect for that. So, okay. Any other products that you're seeing a lot of investors using right now?
A ton of LLC long-term loans. So we can do 30-year, purchases or refinances in your LLC. And the nice thing with those loans is we don't look at your personal income. So it's all cash flow based on the property. So, you know, if you're that full-time investor that we know you make money, you just don't make money on paper. It's a perfect loan for you, because we don't have to qualify you on your income. So we have a lot of people that do that. And there's no limit on how many you can have financed in there, like the conventional side.
Perfect. Okay. Can we switch gears a little bit and talk about 2022? What do you see the mortgage industry rates, all that kind of stuff doing in 2022? Get your magic ball out.
It's a big question, right? I honestly think, and some of this is my opinion, some of it is, you know, the experts out there, right? That we follow and pay quite close attention to, is I think 2022 is going to be very similar to what we saw in 2021. There's a shortage of houses out there right now. And that's the big problem with the housing industry. There's just not a lot of houses out there to buy, specifically first-time home buyer houses. You know, we've had appreciation, and these houses are just priced out of the market in some of these areas. So I think we'll still see a supply and demand curve. Of supply, lots of demand, and there's some reasons behind that, that I won't get too much in detail on here, but there's some pretty cool population statistics around first-time homebuyers in the kind of that 30 to 33-year-old market. For whatever reason, right now we've had this influx of 30 to 33-year-olds, which that is the average first-time homebuyer age. So we have a lot of those, that age group, and a shortage of houses or affordable housing. And so that plays a piece into it. So I think we'll still see house prices continue to go up because of that. And, it feels like rates are going to trickle up a little bit, because they are still so low.
Right.
We've heard some people talk that 2023, we're going to see rates even go lower than where we've seen them now.
Really?
Over the last year. So, it'll be kind of crazy if that happens. I think we'll probably see, and we've seen it over the last 30, 45 days, just especially with conventional rates, it's a roller coaster. I mean, it's up and down, up and down. I mean, we've seen rates in one day fluctuate a half a point, and then the next day they're back, and the next day they're up, and just kind of hit or miss on the interest rate side right now. But they're still crazy, crazy low, and I don't think they're going anywhere for the near future. So, which is good, because as house prices go up and interest rates stay low, you can still afford to buy those higher priced homes instead of waiting for the prices to go down, which interest rates are going to go up in that case. And now you're actually going to pay more for a house that's cheaper than you would by paying for a higher priced home at a lower interest rate. So take advantage of the rates now while you can.
Right. And I mean, good advice for investors, because they're like, oh, we're just going to wait till the prices come down. Well, you're still, it's the same for investors as it is for first-time homeowners.
Yep. It's funny. It's the market we're in right now, but sometimes I'll I'll have an investor who's very rate sensitive. And, you know, we're talking about a $75,000 loan amount. And, you know, the difference between a 3.875 and a 4.5 is like, you know, $20 or something like that on a payment. And I just want to, you know, the fact that we're even talking about investment rates in the threes and the low fours and commercial rates, you know, kind of almost the same, just a little bit higher, is just bonkers. Yes. You know, January 2020 before COVID hit, you know, we're pricing investment loans out almost in the sixes for conventional loans. So, you know, just, it's funny how the perception of where we're at has really changed, you know, for some of these younger investors who haven't seen rates in the high fives, sixes for investment deals. So just keep that in perspective.
Exactly.
Talking rates, so they're crazy low.
When we're figuring our spreadsheets out, just figure out that that's different. So maybe we can, you know, increase our prices a little bit and go a little bit higher. So,
yep.
Any other advice that you have, especially for new investors just trying to start to get in the game right now as far as getting loans?
Yeah, I think, you know, this may be a segue into another guest you may have on, but, you know, one of the biggest questions I get all the time is, should I close these loans in my personal name or should I close them in an LLC? What's your advice there? And it's hard because I don't really have good advice on that, right? Like, I can tell you conventional loans are cheaper a little bit and they have better rates than LLC loans, but depending on what your comfort level is, you know, find a business plan and kind of stick to it and be a little bit flexible in there. But have yourself a very good insurance agent. I think that's probably the best advice I can give you in that question, but I get that question almost daily.
Which we will. We'll be my insurance person of choice is Ted King with Goosehead, and we'll definitely have him on a future podcast. But great advice there. So go ahead and just kind of wrap up a little bit and give us your name and contact information. Yep. And then obviously they can contact me anytime to get a hold of you as well.
For sure. So you can reach me a couple different ways, and I'll give you my personal cell. You know, this is gold advice, you know, gold information here. So use it wisely. But my cell is 317-931-9759. Shoot me a text, give me a call. My email is pretty easy. It's Jared, my first name, jared.shore at financeofamerica.com. You can find me on Facebook, friend me. I've got a couple pages that you can follow, Jared Shore Home Loans, and also Flipping Indy is a page that I have as well. I think that's all.
Yep.
I'm sure there's some other places out there you can find me.
Yeah, which honestly, I didn't know you had that Flipping Indy page. I'm going to go follow that one myself. And just so everybody knows, yes, Jared's a finance guy, but he's very involved in the investor community here in Indianapolis. And he'll be able to give you advice, you know, on certain things and then also steer you in the right direction. Like he mentioned, an insurance agent, because he networks so well in the Indianapolis area, he can kind of give you, you know, a broader network of the good people that are on the ground here in Indianapolis. And there's really a big group of us out there. Yeah. I'll put me in there. I'm one of the good ones.
So. You're a good one.
and he'll give you advice too on the ones that maybe have struggled a little bit. So be sure to call him, ask for advice, you know, see if you can do some business with him. And we just really appreciate you taking the time and being on with us today.
Thank you. Appreciate it, Gloria.
All right. Have a great day.
Thank you.